Hello. In our last session, we had discussed about the main class literature, which I hope is clear to you. In this session, we are going to discuss the main class language, which is classified under 400. But before we start our discussion, I would like to tell you one very interesting thing about the numbers of main class literature and language. As you already know, the number for main class literature is 800 and language is 400. Now see carefully. English literature is 820, German is 830, French is 840, and Hindi literature is 891.43. You know the number for English literature is 820. If we change first digit of this number into language class, it will become 420, and 420 is a number for English language. Similarly, in the case of other languages, if we change the initial number 8 into 4, you get the language number. For example, 830 will become 430, and 840 will become 440, and 891.43 will become 491.43, and these are the number for languages. Different aspects of the language are given in table 4. If you open the class number 400, you will find some numbers with asterisk mark, which guides you to add to the base number as instructed under 420-490. If you open the page number 600 in the main schedule, you will find the instructions are given to add the further number from table 4. Let's coin one number for the Hindi grammar. As you know, the main number for Hindi language is 491.43. If you open table 4, you will find the number for grammar given in table 4 is 5. When we add this number with 491.43, it becomes 491.435, which is the number for Hindi grammar. Let's coin some numbers based on table 4 to clarify the use of table 4. For example, French pronunciation. The number is 441.52. The number for French language is 44. The number for pronunciation is 152, which we have taken from table 4. If we join both the numbers, it will become 441.52. According to rules, after the third digit, a decimal point is to be inserted. Take another example of Chinese alphabet. The number for Chinese language is 495.1. Alphabet number is 11, which we have taken from table 4. When we add 11 with 495.1, it becomes 495.111, which is the number for Chinese alphabet. There is another example of Tamil paleography. The number is 494.81117. 494.811 is a number for Tamil language, which we have taken from the main class. For paleography, the number is 17, which we have taken from table 4. When we join this number, it becomes the number for Tamil paleography. I have coined one number for the etymology of Dravidian language. I want you to see whether it is right or wrong. The number is 494.812. No, it's wrong number, because I haven't followed the instructions carefully. Open the page 616 and you will find there is no asterisk mark against Dravidian language. And the number I have coined has become the number for Malayalam language. That is why I had told you last time also to follow the instructions carefully and strictly. Another common aspect of the language is dictionary. Let's coin some numbers for the dictionaries. For example, the number for English dictionary is 4, 2, 3. 4, 2 is a number for English language and 3 is a number for dictionary which we have taken from table 4. When we join both the numbers, it becomes the number for English dictionary. Similarly, the number for Hindi dictionary will be 491.433. The number 3 we have taken from table 4 and joined with the main class 491.43 and it becomes the number for Hindi dictionary. Another common type of dictionaries are bilingual dictionaries. For example, English-French dictionary, Sanskrit-English dictionary, Hindi-Tamil dictionary. There are two rules which you should know before coining the numbers. Number one, class a bilingual dictionary with the language in which it will be more useful. Number two, if both the languages are equally useful, class with the language coming later in the sequence of numbers. Let me try to explain this rule with an example of English-Russian dictionary. This dictionary will be classified under Russian language in English-speaking regions. The class number will be 491.7321. The number for Russian language is 491.7. 3 is for the dictionary which we have taken from table 4 and 21 is a number for English language we have taken from table 6 as directed in table 4. Let me make this still simpler. I'll put this in a formula. Formula for bilingual dictionaries. Base number, the first language plus 3 dictionary taken from table 4 plus second language taken from table 6. In the above example, Russian language is base number 491.7. 3 is a dictionary taken from table 4. 21 is English language taken from table 6. For the same dictionary in Russian libraries, the number will be 423.9171. In this case, the base number is English language. In the Russian libraries, it will be more useful if it's classified under English language. Let me interpret this number for you. 42 is a number for English language as given in the schedule. 3 is a number for dictionary taken from table 4. 9171 is a number for Russian language taken from table 6 as directed in the table 4. So you can see the class number is flexible. It depends upon the type of library and the type of users you have. For example, the number for Hindi-Bengali dictionary in Hindi-speaking regions will be 491.443-91431. But in Bengal, it can be classified under 491.433-91434. Let me give the interpretation of both the numbers. 491.443914341. 491.44 is a number for Bengali language given in the main schedule. 3 is a number for dictionary taken from table 4. 91431 is a number for Hindi language given in table 6. In this case, the first language is Bengali. It will be more useful in Hindi speaking areas if it's classified under Bengali. Let me reverse this number for you. In Bengali speaking areas, it will be more useful if we classify this dictionary under Hindi first. Let me interpret this number for you. 491.433914 will be the number. 491.43 is a number for Hindi language. 3 is a number for dictionary taken from table 4. 9144 is a number for Bengali language which we have taken from table 6. I'll raise a question. If you have a Bengali Hindi dictionary in Tamil Nadu library, which number you will assign? Because both the numbers are equally useful for them. The rule is to classify first under the number which come later in the sequence of numbers. In the above example, Bengali comes later in the sequence of numbers, and hence the class number will be 491.443914341, because 491.44 Bengali language comes later in the sequence of numbers, since the number for Hindi is 491.43. Let me explain the same theme with one more example of Latin Greek dictionary in the Indian libraries. Both the languages are of the same status in Indian libraries, but according to rule, we'll classify it under Greek first because it comes later in the sequence of languages. The number will be 483.71. 48 is a number for Greek language. 3 is a number for dictionary which we have taken from table 4. 71 is a number for Latin language taken from table 6 as directed under table 4. During our discussion, we were using table 4 and 6 for the construction of numbers. In our next session, we'll discuss in detail the use of table 4 and 6.